So I'm here in delightful, polite, friendly and courteous Mount Maunganui with my new best friend, Jaden. Jaden, I hear you've got a bit of an issue. Tell me, what is your issue?
My issue, Karen, is bags in car parks.
Why?
It's when a car pulls out of a car park, before the next car can pull in, someone stands in the car park and holds it for a friend.
How does that make you feel?
Pretty upset, Karen, especially if you want that car park and there's a person standing there. So car parks are for cars.
Not for people to stand
Not people to stand in, yeah.
Do you think it's slightly selfish?
Yeah. Well, I would think it's a bit selfish.
So obviously, you know, if your bag's in your car park, you need to have someone else in your car. Is it because you don't actually like have a partner or something that means you can't actually do it and that makes you feel bummed out?
No, I'd say if I was going to the beach, I'd have a few mates in the car, I'd be able to get one of them to do it.
Friends?
Yeah.
But not a partner?
No, I do have a partner, but I don't think she'd be up for bags in a car park.
Because she's got morals.
She's got morals, yeah. Hmm. My mates would do it in a heartbeat. They'd be
would
in the
they?
Car park. Yeah.
Have you thought about getting better mates?
Yeah, no, maybe I should look into it. How do we fix it?
Yeah, how do we fix it?
I don't know.
Yeah, well, I'm going to find out.
Perfect.
Okay, great. The logical thing to do would be to talk to the people who set the rules about this. It's a pretty simple question. Can you bag a car park in Mount Maunganui by standing in it?
I asked the New Zealand Police to see if it was allowed, and they said it wasn't a police issue, and to talk to the Tauranga Council. So I asked Tauranga Council, and they said it was a police issue. So I went national, and I asked Waka Kotahi to see if there's a rule that fits all of Aotearoa. But they said they don't set the rules for local parking, so I should ask the council or the police. So I went even higher up and contacted the Ministry of Transport, Michael Wood. And wouldn't you know it, they didn't want to touch the issue either.
Everyone's saying bags not.
Why? I thought this would be easy.
Let's see what other Mount Maunganuians think.
Do you think it's okay to bags a car park by just standing in it?
No.
Nah, probably not, no.
I don't think it's okay because you could, it's kind of safe and someone coming could like not see the person and like hit the person.
Oh, I love to do that.
Do you? So you're a bagser?
It depends how far away the car is. If it's just like, what do you reckon, 10 seconds away, probably okay.
Do you drive a car?
Drive a car.
You drive a car? Okay, so when you're driving, do you think it's okay to bags a car park by standing in it? Chew.
Important things are often hard and complicated, but I'm going to take on this burden for my best friend Jaden. I'm going to find out definitively whether bagsing a car park is right or wrong.
Why won't anyone tell me if it's wrong? There are no laws about bagsing. We all know about it, but nobody wants to talk about it. I keep coming back to Land Transport Road User Rule 11.6.
11.6. 11.6.
Loitering on crossings or roadways.
Loitering. Is it Porsche?
It says, a pedestrian must not remain on the roadway longer than is necessary for the purpose of crossing the roadway with reasonable dispatch. Is that the key to unlocking the conspiracy of bags knotting? 11.6. Roadway. Loiter. If the law, council or government won't tell me, there's only one obvious thing to do. Gather together a group of religious leaders to guide our morals.
So I had an email from my best friend Jaden, and he's got a real issue with bags in car parks. Basically, I just want to know, do you think that morally, bags in a car park is okay?
Don't think I've ever read in the scripture, thou shalt not bags a car park.
Mm-hmm.
Well, first I'd say that there are more pressing and more painful moral issues in our day. Recognizing that, I would say how sad it is. We feel so rushed, we feel at such competition one with the other, that we have to bags a car park. Mm.
If somebody's heart is spacious and they're living a life of generous giving, then they wouldn't think to hold something close to themselves.
So if your heart is spacious, don't steal car spaces.
Well, I think, yeah.
Let's look at this situation from our own house. You have one toilet in the house. What would you do? Would you remain in the toilet so that you need to keep using it whenever you need? Or what would you do is, whenever you need it, you would occupy it, right? So
don't just hang out in the toilet all day.
Exactly.
I'm going to ask a question, and I want a yes or a no. Simple as that. For you personally, as a person, would you bags a car park?
No, I would not, unless I were in desperate need.
My answer would be the D word. Depends.
Jill, what about you? Would you do it?
Confession. I might have actually done this in the past.
We're not here to judge anybody.
The supermarkets bags car parks for, I think it's old people. They've got like two people and a line between them on some of the car parks, and I've always thought, is that couples only? Is that old people? I don't know what that symbol means. So in a way, we already do that, don't we?
Okay, we're getting off topic. I don't know how this happens all the time. I think it might be me.
If it's late in the evening, you're going to Pack and Save, it's raining heavily, and there are 10 mobility car parks, out of which none of them are being used. I don't think it makes any difference if you park in a mobility park.
Well, if there's only one.
If there's only one, then you wouldn't. But if there's 10...
Have you heard of these things, that umbrellas?
Okay, so bagging probably isn't evil. It's dangerous, annoying, but also useful and time-saving. There really needs to be an official call on it. I need to get this changed so I can get some sleep.
All right, bigwigs, you've got one last chance to step up and take responsibility.
I asked everyone again if they would do an interview to talk about making a rule about bagging. Waka Kotahi, refused. New Zealand Police, refused. Ministry of Transport, refused. Tauranga Council, refused. One huge bag's not from everyone who could change the rules. Time to break Jaden's heart.
You're good now, aren't you? Jaden, how's it going?
Good, Karen, yourself?
Not too bad, but I do have some bad news. I'm really sorry to tell you that your issue of bags in car parks is not going to be addressed by the law anytime soon, if ever.
Oh, no?
It's rough. But I feel like we've got two options. So the first option would be that you just kind of get over it and realise that it's just part of life and there's nothing you can do about it.
That'll be tough.
I'm sure it would be. But I do have another option. Option two, which is that we take the law into our own hands.
So which option do you want to go for, one or two?
Option two.
Option two it is.
Let's Perfect.
Do it. Great.
Somewhere.